Peter. Mute. Oh, now you're muted. Now you're going to mute.
Hey, I got to say one thing, Tom.
What?
Oh.
Oh.
Let me ask you something, Peter.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for being here. I am Ruth Unger Miranda. Jay's my dad. Molly's my stepmom. This is the first ever Western and Swing Online. Woo!
Yay!
Welcome, everyone.
I'm just jumping in here, even though this wasn't supposed to be my job, but nobody was talking, and that's my job. I talk when there's a gap. I just keep it moving. I keep it feeling good. We're going to go alphabetical by first name, but of course you want to say hi to Jay and Molly before they kick off this Meet the Teachers round. And of course that was Tom Mitchell, who you just met, playing us into the room. All right. And thank you, Peter Davis, for displaying why we don't play at the same time. All right.
We are. Okay, so this is a great opportunity to welcome you all and welcome Andy Stack to his first Western and Swing Week, this time online, next year on the ground. Andy, we're going to unmute you and let you just briefly talk about your class and maybe play a snippet of music. Here's Andy. We don't hear Andy. Somebody should be making that happen.
Mute. Okay, unmute. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, hi guys. Well, this is my first Western and Swing Week, and I'm really happy to be with you. I'm actually also on vacation in Maine. I'm in a basement at the moment. I'm gonna be teaching two classes. I have a background in a lot of things, but yay, hi from Maine. One is like jazz, but I like to go back to the beginning of things, and I play mostly the electric guitar. So the first great electric guitar player as a soloist in jazz was Charlie Christian. So I'm going to do a class dedicated to just his style, and also a class based on a simple rhythm guitar where you could accompany yourself or accompany a friend with just three-note chords, these kind of chords here. And it's really great because you can improvise on them all day. So I'll just play a little bit of chords based in that style that I want to show you guys about, and then a little bit of a Charlie Christian thing that I'm working on. Hopefully I can pull it off. I have a little drummer here with me, this thing. So it goes like this kind of style. Like that. So I try to put those two things together, and that's what we'll be talking about.
A little bit of swing
and a little bit of rhythm. Okay?
You, Andy. Thank you. Great. And somebody asked if you would hold your guitar higher, and all instrumentalists, when people...
Oh, yeah, sorry. Well,
during the classes, we'll make sure that you can see people's fingers.
Yes. Yeah, and okay. There's my fingers.
And maybe their toes, too. But
that's
we'll talk about
better,
that.
Well, we had a second. Somebody also asked a question about finding the PDF file. How do you get the PDF file of the schedule? That's what it looked
no,
like. But no,
there isn't one.
Okay.
It's right there on the line. A PDF of the schedule?
Yeah. I'm sorry, I'm chewing. But y'all, I attended a camp last week, and I kept going, wait, what's happening today? And I wish it was on my fridge. So for Western Company, I whipped up a handy PDF. Of course, it won't have any last minute updates, so you got to check for a new PDF every once in a while. This is already version 2.0. It's at the very bottom of the schedule on the HQ page. Way down the bottom is a PDF.
Okay.
Awesome.
Okay,
that's
so
great, right?
Our next persons will be Billy Lang and or Russ Sternglass, our percussion team. Are either of you guys ready to talk a little and let us know what you're going to be doing this week? I'm not hearing from either of them, so we're going to move on to...
Hello.
Hold on, we got Russ.
Hi, Russ.
I just thought I saw him.
Hello.
Hey, Russ.
Hey, so I'm going to be doing drum class with Billy, and it's going to be great. We're just going to be going over a lot of different basic techniques for drum set and exploring the whole world of percussion. So we'll just be talking about playing drums with a band, different kind of beats and things you can use when you're playing, you know, with your friends or, you know, in any kind of musical situation. And then Billy will also be showing a bunch of his percussion instruments, his timpani and different mallet percussion things and all that stuff.
Cool.
What he said.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay, well, on our list next is Brian, and there he's in a team of Samantha and Brian Lawton.
Yeah.
You folks here?
Here we are.
Yeah, we are. Hi, thanks for having us. Hi, everybody. I'm Brian.
I'm Samantha. Hi.
And if you want to learn how to dance to some of this fabulous music that you're going to learn to be playing, you should come hang out with us this week.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to be teaching the Charleston class, and Sam and I are both going to be teaching the solo jazz class. And you're probably wondering what on earth that is.
So basically, we'll be teaching swing dance, which means dance is done to swing music. That's what swing dance ends up meaning. And under that umbrella are a million different versions of what swing dance is. We originally would have been teaching a partner version called Lindy Hop, but in this remote version, we'll be doing some solo dances. So Charleston and solo vernacular jazz, ranging from the beginnings of all this in the 20s to the 40s, and all traditional African-American dances born right here in the U.S., stemming from Charleston, from South Carolina, all the way to all the different like webbings up to the birth of swing dance in Harlem. So we're going to show you just like a little baby demo of some of that movement. I'll start with some solo jazz.
Yeah.
And look forward to, in our resource folder, eventually we'll have resources to links on the history and historical videos in order to know the cultural context in which this was created in the African-American culture.
So I'm going to do a little bit of Charleston, and Sam's going to be doing a little bit of solo jazz so you can get an idea of what each of these actually looks like. Here we go.
Fabulous. Thank you.
Thank you. I hope that looks like fun, and I hope we see you in our classes.
Friday and Saturday.
Okay.
All right.
Great. Okay. Well, next up it is more dancing. Cindy and Steve. I think Cindy is with us. Are you there? Cindy,
yes, I'm here. Yeah. Great. So it's just the Cindy of the Cindy and Steve, and indeed we will be teaching dance classes. So we are going to teach partner dancing, even though it's all over this Zoom. But it's designed so that you could dance it alone if you don't have a partner in your COVID safe space. So we're gonna attempt to give you a little bit of both. So we'll be teaching something called West Coast Swing, which developed on the West Coast. It's a certain style of swing that's danced to country, Western music, as well as a huge range of popular music, rap music, R&B, blues. It's an incredibly versatile dance. Normally we would be teaching a lot of Western swing dances like Texas two-step, waltzing, four-count swing. Those dance styles are much harder in this format. So West Coast Swing, I think, lends itself to this really nicely. So we'll be teaching an intro class. We will not assume you know anything. Going from the basics, we'll talk about partnering skills, but also all of your basic footwork and patterns. And the West Coast Swing is done in a smooth style. I wish I could dance it for you, but I don't have Steve with me. You check out our video that's on the website for Ashokan. We'll go through all the basics. And remember, somebody needs to unmute because I'm not going, I think. There we go. Remember that you're gonna have access to these videos for like a year. So even if you don't get something in the class, you're gonna be able to replay it for yourself. So we'll do a relatively fast-paced beginning class that can act as a review class. Then the second class, this is all Wednesday. That's gonna be 1 o'clock on Wednesday. And then at 3 o'clock on Wednesday, we'll be teaching a cool moves and fancy footwork class. So the footwork, fancy footwork is a way that you can express the music more. And so we're gonna be doing three layers of that class. We'll start with a beginning sequence of moves, two or three moves that are a little fancy, but if you're a beginner West Coast swinger, you should know your basic moves and we'll teach you something version of that with some fancy footwork to go along with it. So if you don't have a partner, you can still learn quite a bit from the class. And then we'll shift up to an intermediate level of moves that give you some slightly more challenging moves along with some more challenging footwork. And we'll finally end with some advanced styling and footwork on top of that. So it's a tall order to get through, but again, you've got these videos for a year, you can live with it for a long time and keep revisiting. So we're looking forward, Steve and I, to teaching you how to do some West Coast swing to all this amazing music that's gonna happen.
Thank you, Cindy. That is great. Wow. Now, I didn't mention that this is Samantha's first year and our next person, Danny Tobias, this will be his first time at Western Swing Week. And it's online this year. So I hope Danny is nearby and can join us. Danny, are you ready to jump in? Haven't heard from him yet. I saw him earlier.
Yep.
Yay, can you hear me now?
Yes.
There he is.
Okay. Welcome, Danny.
Thank you so much. I'm Danny Tobias. I'm a trumpet and cornet player from around New York City. And I'm gonna be teaching a class on Thursday called Make Your Solo Swing. So we'll be listening to some clips of some of the great swing recordings of all time. But mostly I want us to play. So it's for every instrument, doesn't matter what instrument you play. And we'll have a chance to practice some rhythms. I'll play and we can do kind of a call and response thing. And then hopefully I can play with some people like back and forth. So that's going to be really fun. And the other part of the class will be how to build a solo. Where do you start? Like, so I will give you some ideas and techniques to build a solo that will swing. And it's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to focus mostly on two songs, Sea Jam Blues and Dinah. So I have a whole in my resource thing, some video clips and some play along clips, if you want to kind of get started. So it's going to be a lot of fun. I hope to see you all there. And I'm just going to play a little bit to end my little introduction. Hey, that's it.
Thank you, Danny. People are doing such great stuff.
Fantastic. I do. This is really exciting. And next we have a couple of teachers who've been with us for many, many years at Western and Swing Week. And they're gonna do they're gonna work together this year. So we're talking about one of the people that you've already seen, you'll see again, Dave Davies, and he'll bring on Harry Aceto with him. Let's hear what you guys have for us. Dave and Harry, are you out there?
Okay, I'm here.
It's a long way from here to Ithaca, I understand.
I know. So I don't know where Dave is, but I think we're just going to be doing some swing jams, one on Wednesday and one on Thursday, and alternating, I think, tunes with Tom and Kevin on Wednesday and with Peter Davis on Thursday. I don't think we can play all together, but we'll just trade back and forth. And Dave will be playing swing guitar and singing. I'll be backing him up on bass, and bass player's job is whatever it takes to make it happen. So that's what I'll try to do.
Yes, I think it's
Friday.
Yeah, it's going to be Friday, 7 to 8:30, I think.
Oh, you're right. Wednesday and Friday.
You get a day off, Harry.
Thank you, you guys.
It's going to be songs from the Great American Songbook, really easy, and I think I just put a lot of charts in the folder there, PDF charts of all these songs, in my key, take it or leave it. And I also hope to have some special guests. Maybe my daughter Lily will sing a couple songs.
Ooh, exciting.
If that's okay.
That'd be great.
More than okay.
So.
Thank you, Dave and Harry. Yeah. And this year, there are a number of great new musician teachers. And the next person I'm going to get to introduce is Ethan Setiawan, mandolin. So great to have him with us. Ethan, are you out there?
I'm out here, yeah. It's great to be here with you all.
And morning.
Wow, there he is.
Yeah, I'm stoked to be here with you all and talk about the mandolin for a week. I'm teaching a sort of basic swing mandolin class first up on Tuesday, and we're going to look at the standard On the Sunny Side of the Street. I'm a little quiet. I can be louder. What else? Yeah, Sunny Side of the Street, we'll play the melody and we'll play some lines. And we'll play some chord melody for that. So we'll kind of run the gamut of stuff that we can do with the tune. And then on Thursday, I'm teaching a class about the mandolin playing of the great musician Tiny Moore, who's really just one of my favorite mandolin players and has a lot of really inventive solo and just great ideas all around. So I'll just play a little bit of that, one of the things we're going to look at, one of the tunes we're going to look at in that class, a tune called Fat Boy Rag that I believe his band leader, Billy Jack Wills, wrote this one. The solo section is a 12 bar blues with a couple extra chords, and then we'll check out some of his solos and try to pull some ideas from that. So here's the first solo from that.
I don't know if you're aware, but back in the 80s, Tiny Moore taught at Western Swing Week for 2 or 3 years.
3 years.
And I think during one of the lunch hangs, we're going to show a little video clip of him
Beautiful.
and Matt Glazer and others on stage together. It's pretty funny stuff, you can imagine. Thank you, Ethan.
That was great.
Wow, another new staff member coming up. This is great. We knew his dad for quite a while, and here is a great musician and teacher on the violin, the fiddle, Jason Anik.
All right.
Here's Jason. I know you're out there.
How's everyone doing? I am so thrilled to be a part of Western Swing Week. Jay and I have been talking about having me come out to this camp forever. And I'm glad, despite not being there in person with all you. I mean, I really wish I was jamming with all you. Ethan, it'd be great. It's great to see you online. It'd be awesome. But we'll have to save that till next year. But what we will be able to do this year is learn a ton from all these great teachers. I'm going to be doing two swing fiddle workshops on Wednesday and Thursday. I think the first one on Wednesday is going to be a little bit more beginner. I will introduce you to a lot of my go-to practice ideas to start to swing, bowing ideas, some chord mapping on the fingerboard, and we'll be looking at the song Minor Swing, which is a classic in the swing world and the gypsy jazz world, that one that you can hear Django and Stefan Grappelli, two of my favorite musicians. So we'll be getting some of the gypsy jazz flavor, as well as some of my go-to ideas for how I approach improvisation in the swing setting. And then Thursday is going to be a little more intermediate advanced, and kind of, if it's a lot of people that came in my Wednesday one, we'll carry on from there. If not, I'll be doing a lot of, again, some ideas of how to navigate the fingerboard when you start to see chord charts, really important. I will talk about ideas like melodic rhythms and swing groove, and give you some Stefan Grappelli licks as well. So I really look forward to working with you fiddle players out there, and we'll have a blast, whoever comes. So I'll just play a little snippet of Minor Swing.
Thank you, Jason.
That was great. That was great.
That was terrific. So, hey, Molly, we're up next.
Oh, really?
We are. Okay. So we're going to be doing some teaching of waltzes. Hey, I might as well say who's on deck. That might be helpful, right, Ruth? John Crum and Tom Crum will be up after us.
Excellent.
Okay. And these will be play-alongs, I guess. Fun to play along, simple tunes.
Some tunes some people know already, and some tunes that are new. So,
and I did put some PDFs in the resource folder.
Great.
This tune isn't in there yet. It's the Cowboy Waltz. Thank you. welcome, and you can even sing along if you want to.
Yes.
So, Molly, I said who was on deck, and after John and Tom will be Junior.
That's right.
Darty and family.
Right now, we'd like to introduce you to two folks who have been there. One who's been there his whole life, and the other one who's just been there many, many years. Please welcome John and Tom Crum. You guys out there?
Hi, guys.
Hi there. What's up? So we're doing a slow jam on Wednesday morning and on...
I think it's the afternoon.
I thought it was 11:30.
Well, that's close enough.
And Friday. So the big thing is it's going to be really slow.
You're going to play a slow thing?
That might be a little too fast. So we're going to have hand signs. We'll figure out, like, if you go like this, it might mean slow down. And if you go like this, it might mean speed up. And we're just going to play anything. It could be songs or tunes of any genre.
It could be swing. It could be other stuff. Really, whatever you want.
There's a few really great benefits about being at this year's camp. Because this is the only camp you can bring all your pets to. You can also, like, drink as much as you want.
That's true.
At every workshop.
Mm-hmm.
And the third big option is you'll never be tuned. Because we just won't hear any out of two notes. We've practiced.
Yeah. All of your notes are incredible. Solos are incredible.
Jay.
Did you guys know that none of the teachers are wearing pants either this year?
Yes.
I haven't worn pants since March. I don't know.
We're beyond commando.
Without no pants on.
Great. Well, thanks. We'll see you. If you want to have fun, we'll see you then.
Yeah.
All right, Ben.
Fun.
You.
Okay.
Sounds great.
I want to tell Katie Martucci that she is on deck, but right now we're going to bring you somebody else who's been at Western and Swing Week for many, many years, somebody I've known since I was 19, which was when I first met him out at the Weezer Fiddle Contest in Idaho, and that was a lot of years ago, I'll tell you. Please welcome the fabulous Junior Darty from out west.
And with him, his grandson, Sean Hurdle, and his daughter, Tammy.
All right.
Stuart.
Hey, folks.
My mom had to step out. She had a meeting, but she's doing right now. We're not really, I don't think, teaching anything per se this year, but we are hosting a few jam sessions that we'd love everybody to be a part of. The first one's going to be on Tuesday from 7 to 8:30. And Yvette Landry is going to be joining us for that one. Then also on Friday, we're going to be doing another country jam that's going to be 7 to 8:30 p.m. as well. And then Paula Bradley will join us for that jam. And it's going to be all ages, all skill levels are invited and encouraged. Welcome to join us and jam. It's going to be a great time. And do you have anything to say, Grandpa?
Let's just play.
Did you guys want us to play a song, or what do you guys want?
It seems like your original sound isn't activated.
The sound is not working?
That's good enough for this.
Okay, great.
Okay. Ready?
So good to see you both and hear you as well.
Great to hear you dragging that bow.
Kevin Wimmer and Tom Mitchell are on deck.
And right now, say that again.
Kevin and Tom are on.
I was saying, 90 years old, still part of the club.
Oh.
Repeat that one more time, Sean. Oh, shoot. Sorry, everyone. Okay.
All right. All right.
Kevin and Tom are on deck.
Right now, we're going to bring out.
Hi. Hi, everybody. So good to see you all. Everyone can hear me okay? I hope. Good. So yeah, I'll be doing a vocal harmony class. And yeah, although I'm bummed we won't be able to hear our voices together, I want to encourage everyone to just sing all the parts. You do not have to hit the right notes. It will not affect anything. And I think it's going to free up a lot of just a lot of experimentation. So I'm really excited to be able to present the material in this way. We're going to do a tune called Me, Myself, and I that I fell in love with listening to Billie Holiday sing this version. And it's a little arrangement I put together. So I'm just going to do a little bit and sing a little bit of each part, and it's going to sound okay. So here we go. All right. Me, myself, and I are all in love with you. We all think you're wonderful, we do. A little high part. Me, myself, and I are all in love with you. We all think you're wonderful, we do. And then a low part. It can't be denied, dear, that you brought the sun to us. We'd be so satisfied if you belong to one of us. Oh, if you pass us by, three hearts will break in two. Me, myself, and I are all in love with you. Looking forward to singing with you guys.
Lovely. Thank you, Katie.
Nice.
So on deck, Larry Bayonne, but right now we're going to hear from Kevin Wimmer and Tom Mitchell.
All right. I don't know who's going first, but I can go first. My name's first.
Hey, y'all, Kevin. That's quite a beard you grew yourself there.
I know. I've been growing it since March, I'd say. Well, actually, I started before then, but it was, you know, it's grown a lot since. I guess I'm a close-up. So Tom Mitchell and I are doing a condensed version of our Riffin' Together class. That's, you know, primarily for guitars and fiddles. So any string instruments welcome, and certainly this year any instrument of any kind is welcome, because you're all welcome to join us. We have an arrangement of Charlie Christian and Benny Goodman tune Till Tom Special. And Tom's put his parts up in the folder. I'm gonna put mine up later. I'm gonna try and add some bowing. But we're gonna have the fiddles and guitars are in two sections of three parts each. A lot of the arrangement is unison, but a few of the sections have some harmonies. So I recommend, if you can, maybe printing out, if you have a good printer, to print out the PDFs ahead of time. Are you all hearing me?
Yeah.
So our classes meet, I think, Friday and Saturday at 1 o'clock. So if you have a chance, you can print out the parts ahead of time and put them on a music stand next to the computer, or if you have a big screen, you can watch, you know, open the PDF on your screen. And if you're interested in playing one of the harmony parts to a few of the sections, you can, you know, download parts, fiddle or guitar 2 and 3. But I recommend everyone downloading fiddle and guitars 1 anyway, because that would have all the melodies. And we have, it's a arrangement that kind of goes like 4 times through the tune. And what we have done, Tom and I, with some help, have made a backing track with our parts. So when Tom and I take turns sort of conducting and leading passes of the song, we'll play that and play along with it. So we'll all have something to play to, that where you can hear some of the ensembles. And one chorus is left with just the rhythm section, so everyone can solo all together at the same time, or we'll do some trading back and forth. we'll sort of check it out. And in between, we can also, Tom and I can break down some of the lines just to show how we play them on the instrument. If you want to check out some bowing and fingering, we can kind of work on the different sections a little bit. But that's our concept, to work on this arrangement together. And as I said, Tom's guitar parts are up there in the folder now. I'm going to try and add mine tonight because I want to add a couple of bowings. Tom and I also have a jam, but I guess I'll mention that myself before we go over, turn it over to Tom, see what he wants to add and what I've forgotten. But we're doing a jam session Wednesday night, and I think we're going to start it off with at least a few tunes of Django. So we're going to start off with a little bit of our Django jam to jam, you know, in honor of our past years doing that at Ashokan. And Tom got some buddies to make a couple backing tracks too. So, you know, if I kick off a tune, I'll have a little rhythm section to play behind me. We'll take turns, do a few Django tunes, tick off the jam, and then we'll pass it up, open it up to just swing. And we're also hosting it with Harry and Dave. So it'll open up to any kind of swing or whatever. So does that sound good, Tom? You want to add something?
It sounds good to me. Yeah, it sounds great. I didn't have to say hardly anything. I hope everybody will come to the jam. Like Kevin said, it's going to be, we'll start off with Django, and then we're just going to go sort of round robin between us, coming up with tunes that everybody can play along with and sing along with if they want to. We might have a couple special guests. It's going to be exciting. And if anybody has any questions about the guitar parts, they can just get in touch with us. It'd be fine. Or fiddle parts.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys. It's going to be
didn't
wonderful.
Play, but we didn't really play much.
Very well, suspenseful, very suspenseful.
That's right.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You. On deck is Laurel Massé, but right now we'd like to introduce you to Larry Bayonne. You out there, Larry?
I am. Here I am. Can you?
Great to see you, Larry, and right. Hear you.
Yes. Let's see. Can you see me?
We got you, Larry.
Hey, Larry.
Yeah, good. It's great to be here. Wonderful. We're going to have a great time. I'm looking forward to having two classes, one on Tuesday and one on Wednesday. The first one on Tuesday at 3:00. It says Intro to Swing Guitar. I'll talk about the guitar a little bit, about rhythm, give you some more new chord forms maybe. We'll play some tunes. We'll go over some tunes and get rhythm guitar happening. The second one on Wednesday at 3, we'll be doing an arrangement of a Barney Kessel tune. And I have parts written and also we'll be playing it. It's mostly a blues with a bridge. But what I'm looking for is helping you in any way to get better on your instrument and in this style. So please come, and you can copy, print out some of the music that I have on the resource page or not, or have it on your computer. So just to give you an example, I'll play a little bit of Just Squeeze Me by Duke Ellington. Thank you.
Wow.
Beauteous.
Thank you, Larry. Larry, and you're such a great teacher. I wish I had you as a teacher when I was a little kid.
Did they have Berkeley back then?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think so.
So before we move on to the next musician teachers, there are a couple of special things coming during the week. One of them, I'm not sure when it's going to happen yet, but some of you remember a past staff member named Jay Peterson, who taught many a year at Western and Swing Week and has also been a radio host. And he prepared a special Western and Swing radio show that will be available during the week, maybe more than once. Ruth is telling us dinner time tomorrow.
Yes.
Jay Peters' radio show during dinner tomorrow. That's great.
That is really great.
And then
great.
Another blast from the past. It's been many years since Matt Glazer has been with us on staff. He's going to be doing a listening session during lunch at some point during the week. And also, on the very last night, he's hosting the long-awaited Joke Off, which we haven't done in a long time. And by the way, that Jay Peterson radio show will air at dinner tomorrow, and then it'll be on demand anytime. All right. So what's coming up, Molly?
Wait a minute. What's a Joke Off? Long-awaited.
Excellent question.
Thanks for asking. I thought you'd never ask. It's basically a session where people trade jokes and one leads to another. Sometimes categories emerge, sometimes they don't. You know, like a porcupine walks into a bar. That could be a category. Kind of sticky, prickly one, but it's a category nonetheless.
Sounds like a great place to start.
Yeah, and we put it on the last night so that if anybody is horribly offended by any of the jokes, the week will at least be over at that point, and they can leave. Thank you very much.
Somebody else will just ask, when's dinner? And I've been wondering that myself, actually, tonight. But I don't know, 6 o'clock? When's dinner time?
Really, whenever you want.
I have to look at the schedule.
I think they were looking at, like, when is Jay Peterson's radio show going to be
on? I think that's what they were going for.
I think it's going to be at 5:30.
5:30
tomorrow at 5:30.
Yeah, and there's a link to it in the HQ page. I inserted it in the schedule, a little link, and you should be able to get it. It's an app called Mixler. It's a kind of a hip way to listen to audio. It's better quality audio than the Zoom because it's just audio and it doesn't take up a ton of bandwidth or anything. It'll sound really nice. You can get the app on your phone or something, or just click the link and follow the click.
And it's going to have some great historic music, that's for sure. I can't wait to hear what he's cooked up for us.
Great.
On deck, Michael Sansonia, and right now, Miss Laurel Massé.
Laurel, hi.
There.
Hi, everybody.
Hey.
All righty. I'm going to be teaching a class called A Voice to Sing With and a Story to Tell. And it's got two focuses. One is some very basic vocal technique and vocal health and diction. That's the voice to sing with part. And then the story to tell is about the lyrics. So often we get so wrapped up in learning the melody and learning the chord changes and getting the music itself down that we just kind of don't pay an adequate bit of attention to what the lyrics say and the various things that they might say underneath the surface, what they say to us and how to communicate that and share that with an audience. So we're going to be really digging into that aspect of singing, especially in the area of lyrics might ask you to go in a direction that's somewhat different from what is usually done with the song. And my favorite example of that might be my favorite example tonight, the song is called Heart and Soul, that we all know is the thing that starts on the piano with dicka 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 dicka, heart and soul, la 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 la. Well, that's not what the lyric says. The lyric is all about sort of a seduction and a lost love and being abandoned. It's a whole different ball game when you look at the lyric, which I happen to have on my trusty iPhone. Heart and soul, I fell in love with you. Heart and soul, the way a fool would do, madly, because you held me tight and stole a kiss in the night. Heart and soul, I begged to be adored, lost control, and tumbled overboard gladly. That magic night we kissed there in the moon mist. And then it goes on and ends badly. Meanwhile, we only know it as dick-a-dick-a-dick-a-dick-a-dick. So we're going to take a look at lyrics and what meat is in there that we don't usually get to dine on. This is about my favorite thing in the world about singing to do. So
I hope you will come to the class.
And I hope you love it.
That's so good, Laurel. Fantastic. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Thank you. Happy to be here.
On deck is Paul Anastasio. And right now we have Michael Sansonia.
Hey, Michael.
Hello. I'm so glad that so many of you are here. This is wonderful. So I'm going to be leading a jam tomorrow night, Tuesday night. And as you know, only one sound source, one mic can be heard at Zoom at a time. And for some people, this is ideal because for the first time, they can go sing out as loud as they want or play as loud as they want. And they don't have to be worried. Nobody's going to be judging them. On the other hand, some people do want to be heard. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I just put my email address in the chat. There it is. So if you want to be heard, send me a request and I will, as many as I can, I'll send you a track. And then when it comes your time, I'll turn the mic over to you. I'll mute along with everyone else and you'll be leading the Zoom, okay? And the details will work out later because we don't have much time right now. But send me those. First priority goes to songs that I know and first come, first serve. All right. And now I'm going to sing something. This is a Sandra Boynton song that some of your parents might know. So the shortest song in the universe isn't really much fun. It only has one puny verse, and now that song is done.
Great.
I'm sorry you went over time there, but real.
I love your idea of making backing tracks for people. That is fabulous. Thank you, Michael. Let's see, on deck, Paula Bradley is on deck. And right now?
Right now, somebody else I've known for a really long time, used to be from the West Coast, but is now from Louisiana. We're gonna bring on Paul Anastasio. And do you have a guest there, Paul? Somebody else? Is Yvette with you? Are you there, Paul?
Working on it, sorry.
Okay. There he is.
Max. Hold on, Paul, you're muted, sorry. We did that juggling thing. Paul, Ed Landry, I think you're on. Start over, okay, Paul.
Okay, I'll start again. I'm Paul Anastasio. I'm a legend in my spare mind, and I've known Molly since before they invented a mud. It was just dirt and water back then. Anyway, we're going to be doing a Western swing class tomorrow, starting at, I believe, 1 o'clock your time, I think. And we're going to be doing all Western swing tunes, things like. More or less. And Chaz Justice is going to be involved with us too. We talk Chaz into coming in. Yeah, Yvette Landry is also on the faculty, and we got together and did some workshops. I'm posting some sheet music, some PDF and finale files for about a dozen Western Swing Tunes. And we also have some little video clips, links to YouTube video clips and that kind of stuff. And then on Thursday, again, I think 1 o'clock your time, I'm doing a Mexican class with Tina Piglione, who came down with me and studied in Southern Mexico for quite a bit with Juan Reynoso. And we're gonna be playing some little things like this, little foxtrot. Playing that, we're going to have a PDF and finale files for the dozen tunes that Tina Piglione and I are going to be playing.
Thanks.
Get a hold of it. And yeah, some of the videos all or the audio is all chopped up. Whatever. Hope you understand. Tomorrow, 1 o'clock Eastern Time, Western Swing with Yvette Landry and Chaz Justice.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you. I want to let folks who are concerned about the internet quality there. Paul will be at Yvette Landry's house where there's fabulous internet for the really class. Okay, so on deck is Peter Davis, but right now it's Paula Bradley and Yvette Landry. At least one of them, maybe both of them.
All right.
Thanks, Paul.
You bet.
We're mixing dirt and water together right now.
Are you?
Yeah.
How am I? Am I on?
Yeah. Hi, Paula.
Hi. Can you unmute Yvette too?
I'm unmuted. I'm here.
Awesome. Awesome. I don't see you. I see Jay and Molly, but that's okay. I like to see them. This is my first time at Ashokan Western and Swing Week, also.
Me too.
Yes. Oh my God,
Both Yvette and Paula, this is your first Western and Swing.
Welcome, so welcome, cool. Welcome. Thank you. And Yvette and I are teaching actually tomorrow morning from 10 to 11. And we're going to sing some honky-tonk songs. I think what we decided, and Yvette jump in, but we're going to, tomorrow both of us are going to talk about some songs that we've written and play a couple songs we've written in addition to some other songs that maybe are a little less familiar. And then we've got a song swap, honky tonk song swap together Wednesday night. And then each of us are playing with Junior on one of the other nights. And we'll try and hit some of the more well-known songs so everyone can jam along and have a big old honky tonk time. Am I right, Yvette?
That's right. That's right. And, we'll also do a little bit, I forgot what her name was. Maybe it was Laurel, I'm not sure. But we'll kind of talk about where our little honky-tonk songs come from and kind of delve into the lyrics a little bit as well. So it'll be a nice partner with that class as well. Yeah, and then we'll do some standards too.
Like this one. It wasn't God who made honky-tonk angels like you.
That has caused many a good girl to go wrong. There you go. Tomorrow.
That is awesome, guys.
That was a super Zoom thing you just did. I love that. Oh, yeah. Well, on deck is Rob Stein, and right now we get to introduce Peter Davis.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, Peter.
Okay.
We see you.
I've been lucky enough to come to Western and Swing Week every year since 1989, except when I had a gig in China and I couldn't make it. But happy to be back. And every year for quite a while, I've been teaching this class called, this time it's called Fun with Chord Progressions. And that is a class where you can learn some of the secrets of how chord progressions are put together and chord relationships and patterns. And hoping that it's not gonna be really a dry academic class, but fun. So for example, if you hear a song like this, that's one kind of thing. Or you might hear this. What's going on with that? Or you might hear. Or you might hear this. Or you might hear this. We're going to be playing together lots of different songs and categorizing them by the type of chord progression that go together with that particular group of songs. It helps you with hearing chord changes when you're listening to music. It can help you with transposing to different keys for your singing. It can help you with improvising to know what scales go with different types of chord progressions. And please, it's going to be tomorrow at 10 a.m. and Wednesday at 10 a.m. Go to my, if you want to look at the handouts while we're doing the class, go to my resource box and print out the Tuesday and Wednesday class. So I think that's about it. And if you've been to Western and Swing Week, and because there's 10 things going on at the same time, you've never gotten to actually try this class, maybe it'll be great to see you in there. This is your chance to do that. Any questions? Five, four, three, two, one. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you, Peter.
Great.
And you know what you just said, if you didn't have a chance to see this class, I think probably everybody already knows this will be archived and available to you, all of us, for a year. So you can go back and see classes over again or ones that you missed. It's really cool. Great innovation. Thanks, Ruthie, for coming up with that. So on deck, Vinnie Martucci is on deck. And right now we're going to go straight to Rob Stein. Hey, Rob, we don't hear you. You're muted. There you go.
Okay. The steel guitar players are always looking down. Okay. Hi, everybody. This is wonderful. It's incredible. I'll be teaching a steel guitar course on Wednesday morning on lap steel guitar like this, tuned to the C6 tuning. But players of any sixth bass tuning or really pedal steel or anything can get something from my course, because I'm going to try to open it up to players of all levels and all tunings and approaches. And I'm going to be centering it on the steel guitar as a blues voice, which I think is really kind of what it's all about when steel guitar plays Western swing, kind of like this. Now, that's a pretty complex little piece of music with a lot of typical Western swing licks, but so is this. Which is super simple. So I think that anybody can benefit from this. And this will open up a few doors for players of all levels. If you kind of isolate what makes this instrument tick as a blues instrument, which is this little interval here. Two notes on two strings, and that's what it's all about. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Rob.
Sounds great.
Well, we're nearing the end. There's just one more person to go, and I do want to mention we're going to move into the jam session, and I want to find out if Michael Sansonia might be able to lead us off with the first jam tune after our next guest instructor.
I would be honored.
Okay, great.
That's
okay,
terrific.
Molly, who's on now?
All right, we're going to finish up here with another person who's been teaching for many years, Vinnie Martucci. You out there, Vinnie?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hey.
Am I on?
Sounds good.
You're great.
You do. You sound great. Like you're only a couple miles.
I'm only a couple of miles away. I got a big voice. So I'm going to be teaching a course called, first of all, before I get into that, it's so fabulous that we're able to do this. Thank you, Jay and Molly, and it's wonderful to see all you guys. Oh, my God. Here we are. So
I'm going to be teaching
a course called Let's Recompose, Not Decompose, which is really not a biology course. It's a songwriting course. And it's based on this concept called modeling, where you take great tunes in whatever style that you love, and you pull them apart, you decompose them, you look at the parts. And as I've been listening today, I feel fortunate being the last person going, because in some ways, most of the classes are, everyone, you know, we all as professionals and teachers and players take the same approach. We look at what's the really great stuff out there and what we can get from it. So we're going to apply that to songwriting. And we're going to do it from the perspective of harmony, melody, and rhythm. But I'm going to break it down really to harmony, melody, and lyrics. So I'm really glad that I heard Laurel talking about that we're going to be dealing with lyrics. Basically, you can use the song we're going to do this week is This Land Is Your Land. It's a great example because Woody Guthrie did not write the music, the chords and the melody. That's a Carter Family tune. And what he did is he put those glorious lyrics on them that have stood the test of generation after generation. It's just such a marvelous work. And I thought, this is a really great piece. So I've spent days just poring over this thing. What I'd like to do for you right now is play one chorus of the original and one of the tunes that I wrote based on it, showing how you can transform the harmony and melody by just looking at the essentials into something that's your own thing, its own tune. So here we go. Now, here's the variation.
Wow, Vinny.
Yeah, I think Woody would have loved it.
I hope so. Well, thank you all. It's so wonderful to see you. And my class is on Friday. and Saturday, I think at 1 to 2, and it follows Laurel's class. And I got all kinds of stuff, all kinds of variations. Looking forward to seeing you.
Great. Thanks so much, Vinny.
Yeah.
So we're going to start the jam section of things here. And first up, the lovely Michael Sansonia.
Thank you. So I think we'll start with my current favorite swing tune, which is Don't Get Around Much Anymore. And the lyrics are in the songbook in my resource folder. So you can go there. And we're all learning how to do this. I think what we're going to do is we'll do three choruses, and I'll sing, be one of the singers on the first chorus, and you sing along. Second chorus, I won't sing, and it'll be for soloists and everything. And then we'll come back and sing on the third chorus again, and we'll take it out. Okay. And we're going to do it in C. Miss the Saturday dance, heard they crowded the floor. Couldn't make it without you, don't get around much anymore. Thought I'd visit the club, got as far as the door. They'd have asked me about you, don't get around much anymore. And now, darling, I guess my mind's more at ease. But nevertheless, why stir up old memories? Been invited on dates. Might have gone before. Couldn't make it without you. Don't get around much anymore. Go ahead, swing. Okay, I just got a note the piano could be louder. I'm turning it up here. Here we go. We'll play one more. Go ahead. Singers, come on in. Missed the Saturday dance. Heard they crowded the floor. Couldn't make it without you. Don't get around much anymore. Thought I'd visit the club. Got as far as the door. They'd have asked me about you. Don't get around much anymore. Now, darling, I guess my mind's more at ease. Nevertheless, why stir up old memories? Been invited on dates. Might have gone before. Awfully different without you. No, don't get around much no more.
Thank you, Michael. Perfect tune for what's going on.
Yeah,
in this
so
world.
True, so true.
Yeah. Okay, let's see. Everyone.
Vinny forgot to mention something.
Let's see what that was. Vinny. Oh, PDFs. Vinny has PDFs in his resource folder. Check it out. Send any questions. Glad to answer. Thank you, Vinny.
I forgot to mention my songwriting. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, coming up, we have a number of people to lead songs. I know Katie Martucci has said she'd like to do one. I know Dave Davies is going to. Why don't we have those two, whichever one first, speaks up first, and then the other one second.
Good idea.
Who's out there? Hi.
Hey.
Good to see you again.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm going to share my screen so that folks can see a chart if they want one. So figured we'd do some of these days. So hopefully this is visible to everyone. And yeah, I like the model that that Michael just put forward. So we'll do that. I'll sing through it once, and maybe it's a pretty short tune. So maybe I'll play through the whole thing twice, and then we'll end with it at the end. And we'll just see how it goes. And I'll just imagine everything that you're playing. So here we go.
Katie, can I just interrupt for just one second?
Absolutely.
About the view of the screen? So if you're participating in the meeting and you want to watch the chart, I assume that everybody's seeing that. However, if you'd rather watch Katie play, there's a button. If you see the panel of viewers along one side or maybe along the top where you'll see yourself and a few others, there's a button that says swap shared screen with video in the top right hand corner of that little panel. And I'll do a quick gallery view. If you're seeing that button, give me a thumbs up. Thanks, Katie. Sorry about
that. Awesome, thank you. No, no worries. Super helpful. We could give it up for Max and all the tech team, Ovi and Ruth, everyone who's keeping us going. We appreciate it so much. All right. Some of these days, you're gonna miss me, honey. Some of these days, you're gonna feel so lonely. Gonna miss my kissing, gonna miss my hugging. Gonna miss me, baby, when I'm far away. Gonna feel so lonely. All for me only, but you know, honey, that you had your way. So don't go even, gonna grieve, and you're gonna miss your sweet mama some of these days. Some of these days, you're gonna miss me, honey. Some of these days, you're gonna feel so lonely. Miss my hugging, you're gonna miss my kissing. You'll miss your baby when I'm far away. You're gonna feel so lonely, all for me only. And you know, honey, that you had your way. So don't go weeping, your sweet mama. Some of these days you will miss your mama. Some of these days.
All right. I don't know if the screen got weird at the end.
Sorry about that.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Lovely. So let's see. Did I say Dave? Dave.
And what you said.
Let's find out if Paula or Yvette or both of them might be able to come up after Dave.
That'd be great.
Well, let's see. Let's let Dave jump in. Are you there, Dave Davies?
Yvette and I are fine going after Dave.
Okay, thanks.
And maybe if we don't hear from Dave, you're on now.
Not seeing Dave. Let's go to Paula. And
thank you Yvette. For unmuting me, Max.
There he is.
Where
were you, Dave? What's David Davies? That's what got me. Sorry.
Me. How about a blues?
Oh yeah.
I was thinking of Route 66. If you ever plan to motor west, here's the byway, the highway that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66. It winds from Chicago to LA, more than 2,000 miles all the way. Get your kicks on Route 66. Waco to St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, Oklahoma City, it's mighty pretty. See Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget Corona, King and Basta, San Bernardino. If you ever make that tip, when you make that California trip, get your kick on Route 66. All playing now. I can't hear you. City looks mighty pretty. See Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget Winona, Kingman, Basta, San Bernardino. If you ever plan to make that trip, when you take that California trip, get your kick on Route 66. Get your kicks on Route 66. Taking that trip.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. If Kevin and Tom are around, maybe they could get after Paula. Is it to bet with you?
Oh my God. I can't hear anything now. I
have a little trouble hearing Jay and Molly. It sounds like their volume is like bleeding through a mic in the other room or something like that. All right,
okay.
Well,
can you hear me better now?
Gotcha, yeah. Jay.
Sorry about that. We were listening through speakers, and I think it screwed up our microphonics.
I'd say yes.
So, thank you, Dave. If Kevin and Tom are ready after Paula, and maybe Yvette with her.
Yeah.
Either Paula or Yvette, or one after the other. Oh. Whatever we got coming right up. Let's see.
Both of them.
Can you hear me?
There you are.
There.
Yes, Yvette's going to join me.
I just want to mention, it is absolutely thundering rain outside of my house, and I don't have air conditioning. So if you hear these loud noises, that's what's happening. It's deafening for me. Anyway, we're going to do, this was not planned because we didn't know we were doing anything, but we're going to do Hey Good Looking. I think everybody knows it, in the key of F, which Yvette and I are both quite fond of. And so we don't have a chord chart prepared, but I think everybody knows it. It's going to kick off on the 2 and then go to the 5 and then come back to the 1. And the bridge starts on the 4. And sing along. Play along, all right? The rain is. Can everybody hear me?
Yeah.
Max?
Yeah.
I think we're going to see if Peter Davis could be on deck as we move over to Tom and Kevin, or Kevin and Tom. Let's see what happens. There's so much good music happening here. Hi, guys. Are you out there?
I'm here, but has Tom got something? Maybe he's got the guitar.
I'm not sure. We can't. I'm still trying to figure out how Yvette and Paula did that handoff. That was pretty amazing.
That was cool.
That was darn good. totally not rehearsed.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You guys have been working on it for weeks. I guess I'll just sing a song. I don't know what else to do. Kevin will be playing in my mind. Let's do When You're Smiling in F. You ready?
If you drop out, Tom, on a solo and hand it to Kevin, he could take it all alone.
Oh, wouldn't that? Yeah, but then, well,
to stop
that's brave, man. That's really brave.
Yeah, maybe that's midweek material.
I'll try it. Just give me enough time to unmute me. But if you want me to, what song are we playing again?
When You're Smiling.
Gotcha.
When you're smiling, yeah, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, yeah, when you're laughing, yeah, the sun comes shining through. And when you're frowning, yeah, it brings on the rain, so quit that frowning and get yourself happy again. When you're smiling, here you go, Kevin, you ready? The whole world smiles with you. When you're smiling, yeah, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, yeah, when you're laughing, the sun comes shining through. And when you're frowning, yeah, it brings on the rain, so quit that frowning and get happy again. When you're smiling, when you're smiling, the whole world smiles, yeah, the whole world smiles, the whole world smiles with you.
Nice, guys, nice handoff.
I don't know, I wonder what that sounded like.
It sounded good. Hey, Ruth, I wonder if you can help me with something. I want to mention to people that on Wednesday during the lunch hang, I think that's the day Molly and I are going to walk around Ashokan a little bit during the lunch hang. We're going to visit with Bill, Chef Bill. Those of you who have been to Ashokan, what great food he prepares. And Peter, could you mute for a minute while I'm talking?
Oh, yeah, sorry, go ahead.
Just for a second. Yeah. That Chef Bill did a special episode of Ashokan Hello, and that was last Wednesday, but people could see it, where he does a cooking show with Chef Bill. So, Ruth, Yeah, she put up a link to it.
Excellent. Oh, that's perfect.
That's terrific.
He's on it.
And there's recipes online there and everything. So Peter Davis is next. And I want to mention that I saw in the view there amongst our guests, Holly and Barry Tashian. And if they're out there, if they would like to lead a song for us, that would be great. Can you text or let us know, Holly or Barry, or just jump in and say, yeah, we're there?
Chat and let us know.
Yeah. But now, here's Peter Davis.
All right.
All right. Well, I have a little song here that's 98 years old, only 98 years old, from 1922. And I'd like to teach you the chords, if you don't mind. The first eight bars are C, C, G7, or G, G7, then reverse it, G7, G7, and C. I think Danny's gonna guess what song this is. Now here's the second eight bars. C, C, D, 7, D7, G7, G7, C. Here's the third eight bars. G, I mean C, C, and G again. Here's where it changes, E7, A minor, A7, that's my favorite part, F, F minor, C, C, G, G, back to C. You know what it is, Danny? No. Well, I'll sing it. One, two, a one, two, three. Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I'm gonna show you around. Oh, bet your bottom dollar you lose your blues. D7th in Chicago. G, the town that moved Sunday could not shut down. G, back to C, on State Street, that gray street. G, just wanna say. E, they do things they don't do on Broad. A minor, F, F minor, U. I saw a man, he danced with his wife in Chicago. Chicago, my hometown. Now I got special lyrics here. Ashokan, Ashokan, we miss you so. Oh, you can repeat after me. I go, we miss you so. You go, we miss you so. Ashokan, Ashokan, we miss you so. We miss you so. Ashokan, Ashokan, next year we'll go. Well, I bet your bottom dollar you lose your blues at Ashokan, Ashokan, the place that Jay and Molly would not shut down. Ashokan, Ashokan, we want to confess. E, they do things they don't do nowhere else. Well, you'll make friends, play tunes and dance. Come on now, just take a chance at Ashokan, Ashokan, that beautiful place. Oh, everybody, play it now, improvise. C, G, stay on G, back to C, stay there, and D7, and G, C, back to G, C, and G, E, A minor, A, F, and F minor, and C. Let's try a riff now. Repeat after me. Vocal or play?
da da ba do ba da da do dee da doodly do ba dee da si 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 so so si si sa su ba do ba dee dee do do ba do ba dee dee do ba da ba do le bo le bi le bo le bo le bo le bo le bo le da da do da da oh Ashokan Ashokan, we want to confess. They do things that they don't do nowhere else. Oh, you'll make friends, play tunes and dance. Come on now, let's take a chance at Ashokan. Ashokan, that beautiful place, yeah. Ashokan.
Mr. Peter Davis, wow.
Yeah.
I love that. Love that.
I'll put it in the resource box.
Please do. I want them words. I want them words. Are Barry and Holly out there? I saw them for a while, but maybe not now. Do you see them, Max?
Yes, we're here. Hi.
Would you guys like to lead a song for us?
Well, we were just eating dinner.
Another time.
Sometime. Yeah, we'll do that on one of your jam sessions. That would be fun.
Awesome.
During one of the jams.
Oh, that's right.
We love you guys.
So good to see you.
Here's Barry. He's here too.
Hey. Hiya. Just finishing dinner.
Just serve your dinner.
Yes. We'll figure out something to sing with you guys.
Great.
All right.
So for all you who haven't met these two, they taught singing many a year at Western and Swing Week.
Yes, Harmony. That is us.
Yeah. That's you.
All right.
So we may go around again. Is there anybody out there that I missed that was ready to lead something? Because Molly and I will lead the next one. Okay, so Molly, I think we should do the Tennessee Waltz.
You do?
I do.
Rather than Vicky?
Yeah, people can sing it.
It's true.
Play it.
So and true.
We like to sing it in, oh yeah, Larry, you're on next. Larry Bayonne is on
good.
Next.
Let him great. Know. Here, I'm going to scoot over here just for,
okay.
To demonstrate.
Now we usually sing it in C and play it in D. We could modulate. These people are cool. They can do it.
Okay.
Let's sing it and play it and sing it and play it.
So CD?
Yes, yeah, C, all the way through and then all the way through in D and all the way through.
Okay, the special funny chord in the key of C is E7th, happens in the bridge. Da 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 da. Yeah. Da 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 da. C to E to F and back to C. And then to D? It's an E chord.
No, it's an F sharp.
Oh, it's an F sharp. I'm sorry, I just said E. Okay, you'll get it.
Okay, here we go. We're singing it first, right? So a little turnaround at the top.
Okay.
With my darling to the Tennessee Waltz, when old Finn I happened to see, I introduced him to my darling, and while they were dancing, our friend stole my sweetheart from me. Everybody. I remember the night and the Tennessee Waltz. Only you know how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing that beautiful Tennessee Waltz. Thank you. back to see. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz when an old friend I happened to see introduced him to my darling, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. Well, I remember the night and the Tennessee waltz. Only you know how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night that you were playing, that you lived for Tennessee waltz. So much for playing along. Larry Bayonne is coming up, but I saw Junior and his family out there.
Yeah.
So if they're ready after Larry, we can have something from Junior, Sean, and Tammy.
That'd be great.
Okay. But first, here's Larry Bayonne.
Hi, everyone. How about let's do Bye Bye Blackbird?
Yeah.
So I don't sing, so you can sing while I'm playing the melody too. And we'll start off. I'll play it and then you can improvise. We'll play it through twice after that and then I'll back to the melody. One more time.
Yeah.
Cooking, man, cooking.
That's so beautiful. Lots of fun to play along with too.
Yeah.
So I was pretty sure I saw our Colorado contingent out there, Junior, Tammy, Sean. Are you folks out there and ready to do something for us?
I don't know. It's a whole different time zone, you know.
I do know
that. Different time zone, but we are here. We're ready to stand.
So before you start, we should check on that technical thing called original sound. Ruth, can you help us get through that?
Yeah. Hey, Max, did you check them at all today?
No, I haven't had the chance. Sorry.
That's all right. Not your fault. Just making sure we're not redoing it. Are you guys on a lap on a computer or an iPad or a phone?
On a computer.
Yeah. Cool. Can somebody check by the little microphone? There's a little up arrow by the mute button, and it says audio settings. If you click that little thing.
Got it.
Sweet. And then click that and then go to advanced.
Okay, got it.
And then the first thing that says show meeting enable to enable original sound, check that box.
Oh, okay.
Cool. And then the next two things are like three drop down menus. If you want to suppress persistent background noise, you can disable the first two and leave the echo cancellation.
Okay.
The most important thing was that checkbox though. And now when you go back to your normal window in the upper left, does it say turn off original sound?
It does.
That's good. That means it's on. Good job, Tammy.
Thank you. Wow. Quick start.
Time for a tune.
We want to play a song that Jay's never heard called New Mexico Waltz.
You got me there. Thank you. Thank you. More from those folks and from everybody tomorrow. So nearing the end of our hour. I think we've gotten everybody who is up for a jam tune. If not, text or Max has a special announcement. Molly and I have something we could close with. What's up, Max?
Great. Yeah, I was hoping that we could announce the Campers Night sign up tonight.
Oh, great. Tell us about that.
Sure. Excellent. Yeah. So on Saturday night, July 4th, It's going to be Campers Night from 7 to 8:30. This precedes the joke off. And I'm about to drop the sign up Google sheet in the chat. So honor system, first come, first serve. Go ahead and sign up for a slot if you'd love to perform at Campers Night. And it's one song or 4 minutes. And I'll be hosting, and I can't wait to see you all there. Back to you,
Jay. Back to you, Jay and Molly.
All right. Let me grab my.
So I think we're going to close with an old favorite there. Oh, yeah. An old favorite that Molly, you've been singing for years, and people have been singing along with and playing along with. It's two chords, right?
It's two chords. I wonder if there's any ukulele players out there. I'm just asking. Maybe we'll find out if there's some. So we're going to do this in the key of F, because I'm assuming there's some ukulele players out there.
Okay. And the two chords are the one chord and the five chord.
That's right. F and C seventh. And we're starting on the C seventh, and then we're going to F. And it's just the same over and over and over. And it's a song by Guy Clark that I do all the time for kids called Homegrown Tomatoes. So timely, this time of the year. C. Sandwich with a homegrown tomato. I'm up in the morning, out in the garden. Pick me a ripe one, don't pick a hard one. Plant them in the spring and eat them all summer. Wintertime without them, a culinary bummer. Forget all about the sweating and digging. Each time you go out and pick you a big one. What?
Homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. What would life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things money can't buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes.
Make your own tomato juice. Eat them with eggs or eat them with gravy. Eat them with beans, both pinto or navy. Serve them on the side, serve them in the morning. Put your homegrown tomatoes on a hot cake griddle.
Homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. What would life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things money can't buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes. Play it, everyone.
Oh, take it one more time. Play it again. All right. thank you, thanks, everyone out there. Thank you, Ruthie and Max.
Yeah.
Holding down the fort.
The crew.
We're going to see people tomorrow. There's about 175 people signed up right now. We think it's going to break 200 tomorrow. It's exciting. And they're coast to coast. People from everywhere in the U.S. and Canada and maybe beyond. Other places. We'll find
Mexico.
Out.
Mexico. Mexico.
Yeah, at least one. Cool.
And maybe, all right.
Maybe other continents as well. I hope so. From coast to coast and the other way around.
Round the globe. Awesome. Round the globe. I just saw Shane is from Ireland.
Oh, great.
And there's more folks in the UK.
Yeah.
And Colorado. They're telling us about it. That's
good night.
They're up late over in the UK. Thanks for staying up.
Exactly. We're telling them good night. That's for sure.
This is great. Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Signing off.
Aw, so cute.
Bye, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you tomorrow morning.